Ballistic missile, U.S. official, fragmented within your tissue. This is the issue once again. It's too complex to comprehend. Outcry from the foreign citizen. The great Shaitan commits a sin again. The situation is complicated. My people was confiscated, so we all geographically related within this domain. But I remain dedicated to the cause and chant down the walls of Babylon without pause. Laws created to keep us all subjugated. Universal interstellar satellite dispersal. Broadcast murder between commercials. After a long day of killing, they look forward to chilling with a Bud Light to help them forget. They the villains. Back to the program. Meme of your mind. Monitoring your actions all the time as you recline on your lazy boy waiting, unaware that you're participating in the great design of Satan.
It's the bomb dropped by U.S. armaments over continents without conscience since Hiroshima. It's the bomb dropped by U.S. armaments without conscience since Hiroshima. It's the bomb.
Remember the Philadelphia, Pennsylvania move bomb and why they murdered woman and child. They can't explain to you why and how. The profile was fabricated so the African was hated and the atmosphere created. People sedated.
I want to take this moment to bring on Imam Abdul Alim Musa.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Ahmaduhu wa astainuhu wa astadihi wa astaghfiruhu. Wa umminu bihi jalla wa ala wa la akfuruhu wa ashadu wa la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu as-salahu bil huda wa deen al-haq li yadhiruhu ala deen kulihi wa lau karihal mushrikun. All praise belongs to Allah. We praise him, we seek his help, his assistance, and his guidance. We believe in him and do not disbelieve in him. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. Allah sent him, that is Muhammad, with deen al-haq, the religion, the way, the methodology of truth. And this way of life, known as Islam, will dominate all other ways of life, whether George Bush Sr., whether Bill Clinton, whether Putin, whether the Japanese, the Chinese, whether all of them, the French, and every other oppressor joined together in one solid mass as they have for centuries, for generations to fight against Islam, it don't make no difference. That Allah says that Islam will rise to its proper position in the world, whether these mushriks, whether these munafiks, whether these criminals, whether these zalimeen, all of them, whether they get together, still Islam will reign supreme, whether they like it or not. Dear believers, it's an honor and a privilege to be here tonight. And literally, I feel really at home because in the masjid, I think I'm about the oldest one. So when I get to talking, everybody look at me like, yeah, yeah, yeah. So when Brother Malik Farrakhan talk about the Grey Goose, I was on it right along with you, except you was coming from Petersburg going to El Reno, and I was coming from McNeil Island going through El Reno to the end of the world in those days, which is Leavenworth. And no, but see, it's good to know that history, because that's a history that teaches you a lot about right from wrong. It's a history that teaches you when you listen to the news and you read the newspaper, sometimes you have to have a certain background to understand what's going on. So when they give you 911, if you have a background, if your friends were people like W.L. Nolan, who was shot down in the yard at Soledad because he was a strong black personality in those days, if you grew up with the Soledad brothers, with Fleeta Drungol and George Jackson, and we all soldiered together in California because we all came up in that criminal penal system. We were state raised, as they call it. State raised means that they get you at 8, 9, or 10 years old, right? And they send you to little bitty baby penitentiaries. Then you go swimming and hiking, and the next time you go out and come back, you go to another one. You still can play and laugh and talk, but it's got a little fence. You go home and you come back a few months later, and now the fence is a little higher. And then you go out and come back, and they send you to some nice sounding place like Preston School of Industry. And then the next place, Duell Vocational Institution. You know, it sounds very nice, but those are the institutions that raised people like the Soledad Brothers, that raised people like George Jackson. And when they shot him down in the prison yard in 1971, any of you that have ever been in the segregation or adjustment center know that you can't sneak no pistol into no adjustment center, right in the segregation, into isolation, inside a wig that's on your head. It is impossible. So when they shoot your brothers down in the yard and then put a pistol on them inside of a maximum security prison, you begin to learn the process of lying, the process of setting people up, right? The people of getting somewhere by setting one group of people up. And so this is the history that we've had. So when you hear 911, those who have had that type of history, they realize right off the spot that somebody's lying. So it feels good here today. The original Black Panther Party, which was started in Oakland, California, by one of them was a pretty good friend of mine, Huey P. Newton, who later on, Brother Huey got strayed a little bit. You know what I mean? And he got caught up in some things. You know, Eldridge Cleaver strayed and got caught up in some things. But I used to live in Algeria with the original Black Panther Party. We used to live in a place called Bab El Oued. And any of you know that that neighborhood right now, for the last 10 years, have been the hotbed of Islamic revolution inside of Algeria. So we came through a long history. Right today, our brother Sekou Odinga is still in prison. We was in Algeria together. Oh, yeah. See, I'm trying to tell you that the people don't know the history, so they just jump up and snatch up a newspaper, and somebody tell you a Muslim blew up a building, right? And they tell you that, whoa, the night before, they was out lap dancing and partying and getting high and getting drunk, but yet they were willing to arise to the level of martyrdom, which is the highest level in Islam. Right? And then they give you a profile of a drug addict, right? Of somebody running the street, chasing women and what have you, right? And it don't fit. None of it fit. And it don't fit because we have the history of this criminal. We know who America is. That's right, right. And so we're not going to go for any more. And we ask you, and we ask the imam in the mosque, and in other centers, to stop being afraid of America. You don't have to be afraid of America. Look, we took our letter that we have, open letter to the FBI, and went right down in front of the building. And we told the FBI what we felt about them. And they just grinned and gone about their business. Because you go down and call them out. But if you hide in your masjid, in your house, they'll knock on your door, kick the door, and come on out of there. And you'll say, please don't bother me anymore. Right, but if you go down and confront that criminal, like any other bully, he'll leave you alone. So we say we shouldn't hide and we shouldn't retreat, we should go out. And all of you here that are serious about your Islam, when you go back to your masjid, ask your imam and your committee and whoever is running the show over there that they should stand up for Islam. They should stand up for the truth. We're in a war today, brothers and sisters. And not to take long, but just to put it in a context so you understand.